What? Luchini pouring from the sky.
Hey everybody, it's your girl Kenlo back at it again, and we are back with the first interview of the spring with JoLeaha.
Hey y'all.
How you doing today?
I'm doing great. How are you?
I'm great. Awesome. So let's dive right into it. So you already know you've been on my show before on the lookbook, and I wanted to bring you on today to talk about your art and photography. So tell us how everything's been doing with the pandemic, you know, just overall. So
the pandemic was a blessing for real. Like, having so much time off of work in the beginning, I really started like diving in, like, how can I make money off what I do already on the side, you know what I mean, in case this doesn't bounce back, you know what I mean? Because right now, I manage a sushi restaurant in the city, so we had a really rough beginning in the pandemic, but we definitely bounced back. But definitely gave me time to dive into really learning photography too, because I didn't go to school for it, so I've just been teaching myself. So like through doing the self portraits and stuff in the beginning, because we couldn't really be in contact with models and stuff, learned a lot about myself, lighting and everything, and just taking the initiative to kind of like learn the professional aspects of things, so I can kind of like actually make money off it.
Okay, that's what's up. So tell us about your art. So when you do your art, what do you think about? What's your creative process like? And like, how is it just every day just finding something you can just put on paper?
So I'd say like most of my inspiration just comes from muses. Like a lot of women inspire me. I think the woman's body is amazing, beautiful, you know what I mean, and I'd love to capture that, but also just empowering women of different sizes, you know, different ethnicities. I like to create, especially in photography, I like to create a safe space, because so often models express how they work with a lot of male photographers and people that just don't like respect their boundaries or give them a comfortable place to just do whatever they want, you know, even just like creative freedom, because a lot of people have these mood boards and stuff, you know, and they're like, I want to recreate this. And when I go into shooting, I just want to like capture the model's essence, you know.
I love it. So when you first stepped into photography, like, how did that make you feel, and what was it like getting into something totally different from what you're used to?
Yeah, so I did start off like drawing a lot, pencil to paper, and then moved to digital. And I had always taken like instant film photos with my friends and stuff, but I really just fell in love with it over time. And I had friends who were professional photographers, like making a living off of this shit, doing really well, and kind of just watching them be successful and see how much freedom they have in their creative process and still making money, that really inspired me to like keep going. And like I said, taking that time to perfect my image, you know, get my style and everything. And I just love it. I love it so much. I love the, and there's always more to do with photography
for
too,
sure,
you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
Like there's always a better camera, a better backdrop setting, new people to work with. It's just
That's
great.
So I love what I'm hearing. There's so many questions I can ask. So with that being said, being as though you're not originally from Philly, that transition from where you're from and then coming to Philly, how was that for you? How has that changed your creativity? Like things like that. How has that been for you?
Yeah, so I'm from a really small town, Lebanon, Pennsylvania.
Okay.
And it's like creativity is not worship there, you know what I mean? Like everybody's a nurse or they go to school for something, banking or something, and there's not many people that succeed as creatives from out there. So I kind of, that's probably one of the reasons why it took me so long to take it seriously, because I was always trying to do something else and kind of ignoring that calling. And then I decided to get out of town and I went to school in Miami. And
How was that?
I wouldn't suggest any of your kids to school in Miami. However, it definitely it showed me myself, you know what I mean?
Okay.
Like it put me in a position to see people being successful doing things that they love, their crafts and stuff like that, so many different options. And I met so many amazing people, like even like the one model Karina I work with all the time, she's probably my favorite muse just because we hit it off so well. And
she had the cheetah print dress on or something like that.
And it's just like being able to connect with all those people. I actually ended up meeting people from Philly out there.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, she's actually from
Philly.
Yeah, she's from Philly. Yeah, yeah. So just through the internet and stuff like that, just kept in touch with like a few people from rec, mm-hmm. And stuff like that. And I moved to DC after Miami. I moved with my roommate to DC afterwards, and met even more people from Philly. Okay. And DC was great, but it was too expensive for me to stay there. Okay. So shout out to everybody from DC, and the food out there is amazing.
That's so I've like, heard. The best part.
Uzanas, I love them. Yeah. And then. So I ended up moving back to Lebanon, and I was like, I can't do this. I can't go from living in these two big cities, having all this freedom, and now I'm back here where I feel like I have nothing, right. You know what I mean? So I was like, my job went on strike, and I was like, fuck it, I'm moving to Philly. And I literally just picked up, moved to Philly with another creative, and just dove in. And even like, though I had a job, I've always been like, it's always been about art.
Absolutely.
And funding it. And I act like for so long I wanted to be that starving artist that just did art. And then I realized like I can still make a living and do my art if I just take the initiative to like separate those things. And it's been a process, but I'm finally where I want to be at.
That's cool. I love to hear that's a blessing, y'all. Well, come back, because I'm supposed to be stretching my heat. Hey, everybody, it's Mo.
Welcome to the Mo Show.
Oh, with that, oh gosh, you're so amazing. Though. You're so amazing. So many things. Wow.
Thank you so much.
Draw to action.
Yes.
Oh, yeah. Tell us about Draw to Action, because I was looking more into it. I'm like,
no, yeah. Oh, it's great. Draw to Action. So Brendan Lowry reached out to me. I don't know if y'all know who that is.
I've heard him on my show before.
He does great things. Okay, he reached out to me, and I just was so excited for the opportunity because I love being able to do things with my art. You know what I mean? Right. More than just show a picture, sell a print. You know what I mean? I like it being meaningful, and they really, you know, he does so many things with the community and helping to fund them in these difficult COVID times, and I'm just really happy to be a part of it amongst amazing artists. Really great collective. Anybody check it out, Draw to Action coloring book. It's not expensive and it's for a good cause, so help out Philly.
What is your biggest advice when it comes to art, you as an artist, and then balancing like your work life and your art life? Because people in Philly, you know, sometimes they feel like, oh, this isn't enough, or they gotta keep putting like their best foot forward. Oh, even though that is true, you know, sometimes we just gotta flow. You know what I'm saying? So, like, what's your biggest advice for those that wanna be that artist?
Definitely, don't be afraid to have a job and do your art too, because, like, especially with photography, equipment gets expensive, and it's nice being able to afford that.
Right.
You know what I mean? Without feeling like you have to take this job, you have to take that job because you need the money. You can pick and choose where you invest your creativity, and otherwise it gets so draining. You know what I mean? And so many people experience that burnout and even don't even continue doing what they love because of that. They feel like they can't make a living off of it, and you don't have to make a living off of it to enjoy, to be successful at it even, you know what I mean? Like, you'd be surprised how many people that you see rapping and stuff have a 9-to-5, you know?
Yes, it's real, guys. Yeah.
You don't know, but they do. They work at Walgreens at night, and it's fine. It's cool. And also, just like, stop trying to create what everybody else is creating, you know what I mean? Like, at the same time, don't think everybody's copying you either, you know what I mean? There's, we're all scrolling through the same thread, you know what I mean? We're all looking at the same influencers, we're all about to have similar ideas, you know? Don't be afraid to release things because you think that somebody else already did it at the same time. You know, there is no right or wrong, just fucking do what makes you feel good, create it, don't listen to the hate, and... Yeah.
And that's it, that song. I'm gonna stop playing with all of you. Okay? I'm gonna stop playing with all of you. But this is your Kenlo back at it again. Make sure you tune in with a new interview from JoLeaha and I. And that's all, folks.
Thank you so much.
Oh, yeah. Tell them where to follow you.
Instagram at JoLeaha Larke. Twitter, JoLeaha Larke XO. Check out my foundation at Minting Them NFTs, JoLeaha Larke on there as well. And yeah.
You already know where to follow me at via Instagram at the Kenlo Show _. Don't forget the _. Stay tuned. I'll be back.
Introducing Phantom of the Dark. Walk through my heaven with levitation from Prince Drench and Deep as an E7 show.